Defending the Iranian nation's rights within the framework of the Non-Proliferation Treaty and the IAEA regulations. This sums up the demands of the Iranian lawmakers as the Iranian negotiating team gears up for another round of comprehensive talks with the P5+1, the United States, Russia, China, France, Britain, plus Germany. This time, the talks are scheduled for February 26 in Kazakhstan. In a statement released on Sunday, the MPs also called on the U.S. and its allies to accept the reality and recognize Iran's right to acquire peaceful nuclear technology.
So far, the talks have been positive. We've brought up a few of our own concerns, and the other side has responded to them. On an expert level, the talks were also positive, but in order for both sides to reach an agreement, there needs to be the will to, and the other side has to show that it is seeking to interact with us and not to confront us.
Meanwhile, lawmakers at the National Security and Foreign Policy Commission say if the West insists on its previous stance, talks will not lead to any results.
The Islamic Republic of Iran has agreed to continue the talks in Kazakhstan because we have always been transparent in our actions. Therefore, the other side needs to be rational as well. If they repeat the same stance, we won't get anywhere. But if they come up with a new logical solution within the framework of the NPT, then the talks can lead to good results.
In my opinion, any kind of negotiation requires goodwill in order for the two sides to reach a solution. Although the other side keeps saying that they want to make progress in these talks, their actions show otherwise.
The MPs also ruled out any kind of deal that would require Iran to give up its legitimate right to peaceful nuclear energy.
The Islamic Republic of Iran has been very clear that it will by no means give up its legitimate right to peaceful nuclear technology. Any deal that they might propose that requires Iran to stop its enrichment program is illegal according to the NPT.
So far, sanctions and political and economic pressure has not discouraged Iran from pursuing its enrichment program, and Tehran has repeatedly said that it considers its nuclear case closed.
Putting more pressure on Iran is not going to force us to give up our right. Instead, this has been turned into an opportunity for us to increase productivity, become more independent, and boost national production.
The last round of talks between Iran and the P5+1 was held in Moscow in June 2012.
Iran says the West's carrot-and-stick policy is doomed to fail. The only way for these negotiations to have a result is for the West to recognize Iran's right to acquire peaceful nuclear technology as a signatory of the NPT. Gisumisha Ahmadi, Press TV, Tehran.